his own as a player and a coach and a scout, and was among the proudest accomplishments of Don and Soot Zimmer. He was a fine man, is that today, and it's my pleasure to introduce a part of Don Zimmer's legacy, Tom Zimmer. Tom?
The first thing that my dad would have wanted me to tell you was he was married for over 60 years to a Hall of Fame baseball wife and spouse. There is no way my dad could have survived without her being at the helm of almost everything in his career. He had many injuries that she had to help him through. It was unbelievable. He came here after a long run with the New York Yankees and Joe Torre as a bench coach. It was a great time. He was in his house maybe 24 hours from the trip home from New York, and he gets a call from Vince Lomoli and Chuck Lamar, then owner and GM of the Rays. We all knew in the family what that was about. They wanted him to rub elbows with their young players in hopes that they would win a championship someday. Then came Stu Sternberg, a young owner, a young group, and brought in a very, very young front office. And my dad would want me to say, these guys were very smart, but they did not know the game yet. But they learned so quick from so many veteran guys around, and I hope that my dad rubbed elbows with them, knocked heads with them, and they learned the game a little bit from him. Matt Silverman was one of the first. He's already here 20 years. Andrew Freeman was here, and we know what happened to Andrew. And then Hein Bloom came along with the young guys that are here now. We saw all these guys here when they were just babies coming right out of college. To think what they've accomplished, and when you do so well, other teams are going to come after you. And we've lost a couple of those guys. But the tradition keeps going on, and Stu keeps hiring the right